It's time for the Giz Wiz with Matt's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1610, recorded on Thursday, February 16th, 2017. Insufficient Suckage. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we have some luggage that is very clever. You can pop the cork anywhere with a portable aerator and a computer that'll cook your food. All next on the Giz Wiz.
It's the same with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing blue and LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the guru of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How are you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing fine, sir. And you?
Doing fantastic myself. Doing well. That's
good. We're watching a little video. Did you buy your house brand new?
Yes.
Oh my God.
Yes. I love that.
I don't think I've ever met anybody
brand new. No one else has lived in this
house. Oh my word.
That means anytime I spill anything on the walls, I know it's all my fault. All my fault.
Know that when you go to take a switch plate off the wall or something, that there's not going to be 90 coats of paint.
Exactly.
And you open it up and there are 55 wires in there and you go,
exactly,
how many people rewired this house and what color?
Yes. My favorite part is that it's tip top electronically and technology wise. Every room has now in houses they put Ethernet cables and they use Ethernet in the whole house. So I have Cat 6 in this room so that and the internet, you know, people who install the internet, they know how it all works, so they just wire all the Ethernet together. So I have wired Ethernet in every room.
Oh wow.
You know, I don't have to run a cable all the way downstairs. In every apartment, you know, I'm very particular about having wired internet because
Everything is
so mission critical. You know, this is my job. And to actually have that in every room, you know, that's
Let me ask you this. Mm-hmm. Is every room laden with AC outlets?
Yeah, I would say. It's a good alternate. Yeah, we got plenty. Yeah, it's not not like you got three on a wall or anything, but you have plenty.
No, but oh, okay.
And they've also kind of, you know, I've gone into plenty of houses or even apartments where, you know, times have just changed. And, you know, this is just a very, you know, modernly designed house. They're kind of expecting everyone to have a computer desk in their bedroom, you know. So they kind of have an area set aside that's kind of the perfect size for a desk and has
great.
A power outlet near it and has an Ethernet cable near it. So there's some really, really nice things like that. Because I've gone into one of my best friends in Oakland. They live in an apartment that does not have a bedroom, but does have a dining room. Because apparently in the 50s, when this building was made, having a dining room was super posh and super nice. But a bedroom, normally you just used a Murphy bed in the living room and no one cared. You know,
oh,
and
so funny.
You know,
yes.
Stuff like that. That's quite nice. So yeah, I love it. Wow. I love it.
Amazing. Now I live in one of those old apartments where there's like each room has one outlet.
One
like
outlet.
The bedroom has one outlet.
Right.
You know?
And it's on one circuit, or it's on the same circuit of all. You know, you overload the whole house, and it all goes down.
Close.
Right.
Very close. Fortunately, they rewired the building 20 years ago. At least they put an air conditioner plug in each room.
That's good.
Which, yes.
Yeah.
So that helps a lot.
Yeah.
That helps a lot.
Yeah. I have electric. Yeah. I don't know what I would do in Texas.
Oh, yeah. You must have.
I don't know what I would do in Texas,
right?
Without air conditioning. Oh, my gosh. That would.
It's the whole house. It's built in air conditioning.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Central air and heat. And this is the first house I've seen. Every room has a return duct. So I have a input air, and it takes out air. There's the fan, the thing's right over there. In my parents' house, there was just one big thing that would suck in air, and then it would run it through the AC, and then it would push it into every room. Every single bedroom, at least, I guess, maybe it's only the bedrooms, have an area to suck out air and an area to put in air, which is interesting.
Wow.
So,
you know, it's reminding me of something. Do you know who Johnny Jet is?
Yes, travel guru just on the Leo show.
Yeah, exactly. He writes a column, and he's very famous. Anyway, he does a tip of the day, and a couple weeks ago, maybe just 10 days ago, and you can probably find this at johnnyjet.com, he had a tip that you should not abuse, he said, but when you travel, when you go into hotels, and I'm sure you found this, the thermostat is adjustable like from 68 to like 72.
Right.
That's it.
Right.
You can move it by 4 degrees. The 4 degrees, that makes it most efficient for the hotel.
Right.
Well, anyway, on Johnny Jet, there is a sequence of buttons that you press on one of those thermometers, like up and like high and low and off at the same time. And suddenly
it unlocks.
It says VIP.
Be a VIP in any room.
VIP lets you have a much more variable way to adjust the and he said be sure to put it back to normal when you leave the room. But I thought that is a great tip.
Yeah, holy cow. The only other travel tip that I know of is a lot of Otis elevators. Otis is a big elevator manufacturer. Some of them, not all of them. But if you hit the closed door button, and as you're holding the closed door button, you hit the floor that you want to go to, it will go directly to that floor and skip everyone else. It will, if there's other people that want to do it with you, on certain Otis elevator models, you hold closed door and push the room you want to go to or the level you want to go to, and it goes straight there, and it ignores everything else.
Oh, that's very good. That's very good.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I'll do one plug here because the current issue of Mad Magazine, my piece, it's the April issue that we'll start giving away this week. I did one of those signs that you see in an elevator. So the object here is if you have a sense of humor, you could cut it out and put it in your elevator because people probably never read those signs. But if you read this sign, it'll say things like August 13th came because the door was slamming on people, couldn't fix it, but made a little sign that says, careful, door slams on people. And then came the 2 weeks later came, elevator is stopping 3 inches above every floor. Remedy? Told the building owner to raise every floor 3 inches. And it's just all ludicrous.
Yeah.
Right. Complaints about chain rattling. I replaced the chain with a strong rope.
Right.
So if you're ever riding an elevator and happen to glance over and read this, I think you'll probably freak out.
Yeah. You but go, anyway. Get me off this death trap. My tallest in the chat room went ahead and sent over that article. Here it is, video how to override the hotel thermostat. Oh. And here's a video. He's pressing one button. It looks like he tapped another. He taps another. And sure enough, VIP shows up. And you have access. Wow.
Yeah, because it drives me crazy. Sometimes I want the room a little warmer than they can make it, especially in Vegas where they don't have a lot of cold. And so they make it so that you can raise the temperature by 1 degree.
Right. Right. Exactly. So, or you get in and you know, the room is situated stuff that right next to the thermostat, it seems cool, but over by the beds, it's super hot. And so you're just like, come on, keep running, thermostat. Just don't give up on me now. Now, when you set it back, you know how it said the VIP? I wonder if it says NIP, not important person, as you set it back towards the default.
That would be very funny. It probably says it just for 1 minute. Yeah, let's jump into the show. Okay, we're going to finish up the Housewares preview, which is a lot of fun, as I mentioned last week. The Housewares preview in New York is actually a preview of the big Housewares show in Chicago. So we get to see stuff even before it's shown next month in Chicago. And it was more than just kitchen gadgets. For example, take a look at the luggage I found at the show. Here it is. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at, I'm reading his badge, One Take Theater here at the International Home and Houseware Show Media Preview, okay? So, what would you say if I said this and this are the same thing? You would say, oh, Giz Wiz, you've got to be kidding.
You've gone mad.
Well, Stephen here invented this. So you did invent this, right?
I did, correct.
Okay, so demonstrate how this gets to be that.
Okay, sure. So basically, this is a pouch that obviously you could store anywhere in a drawer, on a shelf. You just kind of flip it inside out. The fabric goes inside, outside of the wheelbase, and then you just zip it up all the way around like that, right? And what's nice about this also, right, so this you would have your carry-on. And what's nice about this also, if you want to show this bag again, yep, is you could actually make this bag into a larger check-in suitcase, right?
So okay, how do you do? I'll move out of the way a little.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Out of my way, all right?
So already, he's pushing me out of his way.
So if you see this wraparound zipper over here, and then just like that, magic. So now you can fit.
Oh, the Viagra suitcase. This is amazing.
Exactly. Becomes bigger and it folds up. So you could store it easily and you could get as much stuff in it as you want to get, depending on how big you want it to be.
Okay, now give me the price point. And do you make different sizes?
Yeah, so we make this bag, it's called a zip sack. We make a carry-on size, a mid-size, and like a super ultra large one. All of them fold up into that small pouch the exact same way that I just showed you. And the carry-on size is $69.99, $79.99 for the mid-size, and $99.99 for the large size. Now, the expandable one that we're showing here for the very first time is going to be available in May, and it's going to be $89.99.
And that's this one here, right here.
That's the expandable one that we just demoed for the first time here at the media show for the Housewares Association.
Hey, that's really great. So we got a media preview. So the badge was not lying. $89 in April?
It's going to be available in May.
In May.
Yeah, and right now we already have these zip sacks available in three sizes. Actually, more than that. We have backpacks. We have all kinds of bags that fold up the way I just showed you in different styles.
Okay, and your website?
www.biaggi.com.
This is really neat. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv.
What a Biaggi idea. So Biaggi. Interesting. I know that there's even family members that I have that love this type of thing. They want to bring one bag, buy enough stuff on vacation that they need a second bag to bring it all home. And
yeah, and that's a perfect use for this.
This is the perfect use for that. So, and it looks a lot nicer than, say, just a duffel bag. It has some nice features that it has the wheels and some. It looks like a little bit more structure and even the option to make it smaller or larger depending on how much you have.
And it looks like there's a shoulder strap that also can be used to drag the bag. It's very clever.
Yeah, I agree. I think this is really nice. Also, the price isn't too bad.
Not too bad.
I think that's a very reasonable price. $70 for the one that was demonstrated on the video. And they go up in price as you get even larger and larger, all the way up to a maximum of $99.98 and a minimum of $59.99.
Exactly. And the newest one is going to be in between them. The newest one that he showed that can go, it looks like it's almost going to be bigger than the one they have. It's going to be $89.99. So it's pretty neat.
And what fancy colors, many colors.
Yes.
Lots of colors to choose from. That's amazing. You got to talk to the inventor as well. That's not every day.
I should have asked him how much money he got from the sharks.
Oh, yes. He was on Shark Tank.
He was on Shark Tank. Yes.
Interesting. I was going to say, why not Kickstarter? Why not Kickstarter? We've seen so many products on Kickstarter. No, I'm just
kidding. I know. Shark Tank is probably faster, although
right.
at the hardware show, there was some guys there I saw that had a great idea. It was a power bar that came in wood grains.
Oh.
So if you wanted to screw a power bar to the wall and you had a nice house, you could get it in oak or mahogany or whatever. And I met them the following year and they had a little sign up as seen on Shark Tank. And I said, what's it like being on Shark Tank? And he said, you are on with the – have you ever watched the show Shark Tank?
Yes. Oh, yeah. And oh, okay. For anyone who doesn't know what we're talking about, it's a show where an inventor goes and talks to investors, very, very famous investors. You probably recognize most of the names, and tries to get them to invest in their business. And
right.
In a nutshell.
Yes. He said the sharks question them for an hour.
Oh, yeah. And they cut it down to 15 minutes.
Yes, or less.
Yeah.
And he said they want to know everything. Your cost of this, your cost of that, your cost of that fabric. How fast can you make it? And he said it was a real learning experience.
Yeah.
And they do it all day long for 3 or 4 days. They tape a bunch of shows in a row. And I'm thinking, boy, I don't want to be the one pitching the product the fourth day, the
right.
last.
You walk in, the sharks. Oh, my God. Okay,
yes, exactly. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
A battery screws onto a
seen
wall.
It.
Okay.
Seen
yeah.
it. Seen it. Or that, or they want to go home
all
and they
right.
go, oh, you want $500,000. I'll give you $500,000. Go home. Okay. Here's $500,000.
Enough. Enough. You know what? I'll give you $1,000,000. Just shut up. Okay. Next. Yeah, exactly.
Anyway, got off on a tangent there, but the Biagi people were on the Shark Tank. Our next little guy here, I'll show you that. We could do a little quick, what the heck is it? I can't show you
remote.
Too much.
A shoe, a shoe for a very thin person. I don't know.
Oh, wait a second. Our chat room has come to the rescue. The guy with the luggage got $500,000.
Ooh, half a mil.
From Lori
Gerner.
Oh, yeah, she's like, I think her nickname is the Queen of QVC.
Yes.
So when she gets behind it, so he sold a third of the company for $500,000. But with QVC behind you, that's pretty good.
Yeah. Pretty good.
That's pretty good. Anyway, back to that chat room. Any ideas? Someone said a shoe remote, a doorstop.
Okay. I really don't know.
The video will reveal all. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz at the International. I always have to look at the badge. It's very complicated. It is the 2017 International Home and Housewares Show Media Preview. That's me, folks, media. Okay, on gizwiz.biz, what the heck is it? All right? You can't guess it. I'm telling you now, you can't guess it. However, if I show you this, you might guess it, but we're going to have Eugene actually explain what it does and how it works. Oh, it's running. Okay. Go ahead. Tell us about it.
This is our pocket wine aerator. It's a little device. You carry it with you on the go. You open it up like this. You insert the rod. You place it in your glass of wine. You press the button, and it starts aerating the glass. It has three settings there, white wine, red wine, and port wine. It takes about 30 seconds for a glass of red wine. It really opens it up. It removes those off flavors, the tannins, brings out the florals, the tertiary aromas, really heightens the wine. You can take your $10 bottle and easily make it into like a nice $20 bottle. So it's really good. You know, you take it with you on the go, bar, restaurant. It's a great social piece, you know, conversation starter. It's $19.95 retail. You can find it online, epare.com or on Amazon.
Okay, and it runs on AA's?
There's two AAA batteries, and it comes with the AAA batteries. So it comes out of the box, 1995, ready to go.
And do you know about how long how much battery life will have?
We've never actually tried. You won't be changing the batteries often. It really doesn't use that much
That's
energy.
That's a weird
it's
answer.
It's a small air pump. It doesn't require that much.
Okay. And
for regular use, we'd probably say it lasts for 6 months without changing the battery.
Okay, turn it on again, because there are LEDs on the top.
Yeah, there are LEDs on the top to let you know which mode you're in. So there's the three modes. And when you press it another time, it cycles into the next mode. The modes are pre-timed. And every time you press the button, it only runs that cycle mode. So it won't add time. It'll run just the amount of time that it has to run. So even though you have a pause in between the pressing, it'll only run the desired cycle. So it's very...
And finally, the correct pronunciation.
Our company name is Ipare, and this is the Pocket Wine Aerator.
Ipare Pocket Wine. And it was $20?
$20,
you can make a $10 bottle of wine look or taste like a $20 bottle of wine.
Double your
value. Yeah. And so now I'm going to start buying $5 bottles of wine to give to people and tell them that it's a $10 bottle of wine. And when they use this, they'll think it's a $20 bottle of wine. I've been drinking too much wine. Dick DeBartolo, Manager Editor, right, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at the House Wiz Preview Show 2017. Bye.
Very interesting. I do think that one of my favorite questions in the chat room from Pete Dullboy is, can't you just do that with a straw? Couldn't you just...
Oh, you know, wait a minute, you know, maybe.
Could it just blow bubbles into your wine?
You know what, maybe you can. Now, are you a wine drinker?
I do drink some wine.
Okay.
I do drink some wine, definitely.
You know the difference in wines and stuff?
Mostly, yeah. Definitely.
Oh, okay.
I know the difference between a Cab Sav and a Merlot and, you know, that
Oh,
sort
my
of
God,
thing.
Wow. Wow, look at him throwing those names around.
Woo, dang.
William Gaines, the publisher of Mad, was a big wine fan. He took me to this $300 wine tasting. I said, Bill, you're wasting your money. He said, no, just come, we'll just have some laughs.
Bill, I'm sorry to tell you, but all of this juice has gone bad. This is bad grape juice. This is all of it.
No, when it was over, he said, so what did you learn? I said, well, that dark one is the red, and that lighter one is that's the white, right?
So
a little early, Dennis and I tried this, and I basically think all wine is very bitter and very strong. Mm-hmm. So we tried it twice. Both times, I guessed the aerated wine.
Oh, good.
Dennis guessed it once, but the other time, he liked the non-aerated wine because he said it was deeper and richer.
Right.
I liked it because I didn't feel there was any bitterness in the wine. So
right.
Aerating, it seems to do something.
It does.
But the thing is, there are these aerators that are like $60 and $80.
Right.
And I'm thinking, although the straw is probably a good idea, this seems like a kind of a medium way to go for $20.
Yeah.
It folds up. The little straw thing folds in the back.
Right. Can you use that as just an actual straw? You know, just
I don't think so.
Just suck up your wine. Yeah, there's definitely, you know, this is something that is so personal preference. I know some people that they won't touch wine unless if it's been aerated to their, you know, exacting standards. I tend to not be that picky. I do notice that there is a very big difference between aerated and non-aerated wines. You can sometimes tell if, so you open a bottle and your first glass kind of tastes a little bit, a little bit bitter, a little bit heavy. It kind of just has a little bit of extra kind of oomph. And then, you know, after a while and people have been passing around the bottle, you know, there's new air in there, it tastes a lot smoother. It could also be because you've had one or two glasses. but yeah, so I don't think it's like pseudoscience or anything like that. I do think that there's a difference. And you know what? $20 for a portable aerator, not too bad. I've seen a whole bunch of different types. I mean, I've seen some where you pour the wine through something that makes sure splash it off the walls of this device to get air into it. And I've seen all sorts of stuff. So,
You know, I just realized when you were saying the straw, I actually didn't realize I aerate coffee at the office. for the following reason, is sometimes they don't have real milk. Mm-hmm. And they just have that non-dairy cream of stuff,
yeah.
which I found was lumpy at the bottom. And I started getting two cups and over the sink, pouring the coffee back and forth.
Right.
And getting lots and lots of bubbles in the coffee, which not only mixed up the non-dairy stuff, which I think is polypropylene or something, but I guess – It not only mixed it well, but maybe aerating coffee helps the flavor.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you should bring it to work and see. If
yeah, you
just
know
leave
what?
It in
no,
the
we'll
coffee.
Make we'll make one in brown.
Exactly.
And we'll call it the Coffee Rater, and we'll charge $30.
And we'll launch it on Kickstarter. yes, absolutely. I love absolutely. It. You can get this for $20, $19.95 on their website, or also it's currently available on Amazon Prime, which is fantastic.
Prime.
So aerate to your heart's content. The people who want it, you guys know who you are. Pretty convenient, and I think it's. I'm amazed that he didn't know how long the battery life lasted. Like that's like, you know, we never tested it. We don't know.
We were so drunk by the time we aerated five bottles of wine, we kept forgetting.
By the time the batteries ran out, we couldn't remember our own names. Let me tell you. What in tarnation? So there you go. Okay, next gadget.
And the batteries come with it.
Good.
There's going to be two. So I found this neat toaster oven again from Hamilton Beach Well, I was walking by again, and I said, you know what? I didn't notice this before. So we'll see that video first. And then I was talking to Leo about kitchen appliances, and he said, oh, you should know what I just bought.
Oh,
so we'll do my video for Hamilton Beach first, then I'll show you what Leo bought.
Sorry about that.
No, that's okay. That's all right. Go ahead. Do it. DeBartolo, Mads Medest writer, and the Giz Wiz. Still at the House Wiz 2017 preview, we found something else that's really neat from Hamilton Beach. And so we asked Pat to tell us about this other new gadget. And I like the look of this, but I'm not quite sure what it does.
This is our two-in-one oven. So it's actually a toaster and toaster oven in one. So you can use it as an oven, and we have a big...
But you know, aren't most toaster... Can't you do toast in most toaster ovens?
You can, but a lot of people like the convenience of popping toast in the top and pushing the lever down and toasting bread that way.
So this is like a toaster in addition to an oven.
Absolutely.
Oh, okay. Show us that. Okay.
Okay, so if you're using it as an oven, you can see the capacity is big enough that you can do baked goods like muffins. It will do a 9-inch pizza or any other things that you like to do in a traditional toaster oven.
Okay.
But with this one, you can switch it on the top and use it as an actual toaster.
Oh, great. Okay.
So the wide slot, you can do, you know, really wide artisan bread or really thick cut bread, and it works just like a toaster.
The toast drops down, pops up when it's done.
Right.
Wow, that
absolutely.
Is nice.
Absolutely. Wow. And
Is this aluminum?
Yes, and wow. It has a front access crumb tray, which is really nice for easy cleanup.
Excellent. Now, what's this going to retail for?
It'll be about $79.99, and it'll be available in April.
In April.
Mm-hmm.
That is really a great-looking unit. I like that. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye!
I really like the design with the large opening at the top that's so large that you can set two pieces of bread in. But it could also, be used for, you get artisan bread that's like, you know, super long, and you want to toast something like that. That's actually really nice. I really like that.
Yeah, it's very clever. And it's just a big knob in the front that shuts the oven and opens the toaster slot. So you can't do two things at once. And I thought $80, it was really well made.
I agree. I'm seeing on my Twitch chat, people are saying $80, not bad. And people were guessing the price, and I see $150 was the guess.
I should have asked. Good. Hamilton Beach seems to do very reasonably
right.
I was talking to Leo last week about the spiralizer, And when I told him the price, he said, that's just $50. You know, it's kind of amazing. But then Leo said, well,
let me tell you.
Let me tell you. All right. So $80. Oh, the chat room thinks it should have cost more. Well, let me show you an oven that does cost more, okay? So we're going to run the little 90-second
video
from the company.
The
guess the price.
Okay.
Okay?
This is the June Intelligent Oven. It's a computer that cooks and toasts and bakes and roasts and broils. The moment you put in your food, June starts to pay attention.
What?
Overhead LED lights show you exactly how good your food looks, and the built-in camera can actually recognize what you're cooking.
Okay. You can watch it cook on your phone.
Oh my gosh.
Now you can
start post it to Instagram, of course.
Let's take something you've made a million times.
You can't put a turkey in there.
See this probe? It knows when this chicken reaches a very specific core temperature. Once it does, June turns up the heat. The outside is crispy, and the inside stays nice and juicy. But what if you're at a loss for what to make? Happens to me all the time. You get access to tons of delicious recipes, each handcrafted for the June oven. It automatically recognizes the most common things we cook. The more June users there are, the better it gets. There are plenty of ways to make food. With June, you make food better.
Okay, this is $1,000.
Okay, that's a couple of other things. It recognizes most foods. Like you put something in it, and the screen says, it looks like you want to make bacon.
It looks like you're creating a a human hand. No. wow, a steak. Wow.
Anyway, well, someone must have just okay. So I think someone just looked it up. $1,299, $1,799. Mom's word says it's $1,500.
Oh my gosh! I have no.
It is $1,495.
Oh my gosh! Even when I said it was $1,000, I was not even there.
You were two thirds of the way.
Two thirds. Holy cow!
Yes, and Leo had a very funny thing. For some reason, every other time it says to him, are you trying to make strudel? It seems no matter what he puts in there, it says...
Do you want to make some Pop-Tarts? Are you making Pop-Tarts?
That would be funny, wouldn't it, to put in the world's most expensive steak, and it says, is that a Pop-Tart?
Is that a Pop-Tart? You making Pop-Tarts? That does not, anyway, that must be the tiniest turkey ever, because there's no way.
That's, no, I know. Huh. Maybe it's a squab. Who knows?
This is actually a city bird. What is it called? A pigeon.
A pigeon. Right.
Oh man.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's called the June Intelligent Oven. And you can watch your food cook on your phone because of the video camera inside. And I assume that you can watch your toast cooking, and then when you see it just perfectly the way you want, you can probably say, stop there!
Don't go any further!
Eject that toast!
Yeah, okay, people are saying that's a chicken. That looks crazy. That is too much. For that price, you could buy an entire kitchen, basically. You could get a stove, a range, pots and pans.
Well, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Don't forget the web refrigerator from Samsung is $5,000. The same refrigerator without web is $3,000, but it's, you know... It's a lot of money.
Yeah, it is. But, it is.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we know that most of the people in the chat room will be buying the June oven now. It's just a small down payment.
No, someone said they're going to wait for the September oven.
August. Yes.
Right.
That's a good naming scheme.
Someone is going to go to the $400 store.
Right.
And find it there.
Right.
That's very funny. That's very funny. Eric
oh my
Duckman.
Gosh. Okay.
Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, so that finishes up our, and they always say to me, could you please say the name of this event correctly? And that's why in these videos I try to say it correctly, because evidently I have not been doing it.
You've been called out in the past.
Yes, exactly. Calling things that they aren't. Okay, so now that brings us to Chad's crappy or not so crappy.
We don't know anymore.
No.
It's different every week. Get it. We'll find out. I'm actually not sure about this one, if it's a crappy or not so crappy.
Well, the fan was great.
The fan was fantastic. It was fantastic. I actually have it back here. I wanted to turn it on and leave it on, but it's kind of loud in the background. Uh-oh.
Oh, okay.
It's my computer. I plugged it into the TV, and it
recognizes
that I turned it on.
It looks like we're making porn movies here with my face covered with a black ball.
It's like, you're not allowed to see.
Can I look over there? Can I look over the bar and see what's going on, please?
There we go. Turn that away. Okay, so what we have today, remember, this is the Desk Toys Crappy Corner Month. And I found this little guy. It was too cute to pass up. And we'll find out if it's any good or not, whether the crappiness is still up for debate. This is the Henry Desk Vacuum. So this is a little vacuum cleaner for your desk.
The graphics are nice.
Yeah, I thought that it was pretty adorable. It could sit out on your desk. You know, I remember, that's it. Oh, there's nothing else in there.
Oh,
okay.
Wait a minute. No, it's got to be a little hose or something, right?
How does this work? Uh-oh. I thought, there's no way that I'm not going to understand how to work a vacuum, but apparently there is. Okay, here we go. Instructions? There's no instructions.
Probably on the box. Back.
That's a lot of instructions, if that's the instructions. First off, I do know that there's no batteries included. It takes three AA's. There we go. Finally got it open here. We have our little accessories,
there we go.
Here we are.
We need the brush.
You have
the hose.
A little extension cord hose. You have a, the wedge vacuum.
The nozzle thing.
This is a little bent hose. Of course, you have the normal vacuum and an actual changeable hose. We do have right here, this is where all of the electronics are. Unfortunately, we will not be using the toy driver to open this bad boy up, but we do have a little screwdriver. This is one of those gadgets that has the dreaded itty-bitty screw to keep everything together. This is kind of an interesting setup. It does require three AA's, so this first slot, there's only two, the first slot requires you to shove a AA way back there. So we have some rechargeables. We're going fully rechargeable here on the Giz Wiz.
Okay.
So we'll try to slide this down in there. Oh, and of course I don't
got to be under the ribbon.
Yep, I got to put the ribbon down there. Otherwise, I'm going to have a heck of a time getting these out.
Yep.
Okay, ribbon is underneath. Here we go. One, two, and it's on! Turn off! Okay, there we go. Turned it off. Let's set this back on. Now, in order to test this bad boy out, we have to get something dirty. So, there we go. It's on. And you attach the tube right to his nose, which I thought was pretty adorable. We have a little thing right there. Let's attach another attachment. And finally, let's do the slotted vacuum. There we go. So to test this bad boy out, let me get rid of all of these things. I have with me a keyboard that no longer works. So this is a broken keyboard. But we'll still be able to get in there and try to clean off some of these keys, because I thought that would be basically the worst case scenario. We have some saltine crackers here.
Oh, wow.
There we go. So we're going to...
This is like a real laboratory demo.
This is cute. I would challenge you to find a better demo, even on QVC. So we're going to take this. This
wow.
is worst case.
Forget good housekeeping seal
oh
of approval.
Gosh.
This is Chad's personal seal of approval, possibly.
Okay, here, first I'm going to take the nozzle off. We're going to try to get the big
pieces.
Yeah,
those are big crumbs.
Oh, it's working. It's doing pretty good. Yeah, these crumbs are almost too large to fit into the actual vacuum.
This is better for like getting sand out of your bathing suit.
It's going to take a little bit of time. I really did kind of mess this keyboard up pretty bad. Here, let's attach the nozzle. You can hear it going.
Yep.
I think probably if this was your keyboard, the first step would kind of be to do...
Yes, to do that.
Do this exactly. this th- sort of yep. sort of situation. Good thing that the Giz Wiz here is... We've put this studio through its paces a few times, so it's a little bit hard to see, but there's definitely some stuff down here in the cracks.
Okay.
And my professional opinion is it's not doing that great of a job.
Oh, okay. Is this a five below thing?
No, this was an Amazon product.
Oh, okay. Oh, is it more than $5?
It may be, yes.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Okay, here. This is the... I'm trying to feel if there's any suction. And I
maybe
can't.
Maybe there's a piece of cracker in there.
Maybe there's something down in the tube. Nope. Tube is... Huh?
Are the batteries in backwards? It's not blowing out, is it?
I cannot feel. It's starting to make a sound.
Oh my gosh.
I'm worried. Okay, so I think this is a bust. Okay, let's try this one more time. We have some... It's barely sucking anything. But you can see that it's sort of cleaning it up.
It's sort of, but, I mean, this would be, you would have to hire someone for 40 hours a week.
Now, remember, I mean, best case scenario, it's all kind of stuck inside the tube here.
Oh, okay.
Best case scenario, you know, this, you wouldn't be cleaning this much stuff. You know, I'm kind of putting it to the extreme. I mean, obviously...
You know, how about if you take the hose off and just put your finger right in where the hose goes? Do you feel any suction there?
Not really, no.
No? No?
No.
Okay.
I mean, I really can't...
Oh my gosh.
There's none. Look at all the little stuff we got. We did capture quite a lot. I would say, you know, that we're really putting this... It's almost unfair how, you know, obvious this thing isn't going to clean up all of this, right? But I would say that it is pretty underpowered, even though this is a worst-case scenario. Seeing some of the, you know, I'm just trying to pick up these little itty-bitty amounts of dust here. And it's barely pulling this off. I don't know. I keep switching between, nope, it's not working at all, and I guess it's kind of working. Well, I guess it sort of works. I would still say get a real vacuum. So, okay, let's talk about the price and see if that changes anyone's opinions on the Henry Desk vacuum. We have this listed at $13.40.
No.
No. At that price, you could probably pick up an actual...
You know what? Loke just somebody put up a thing that said, look at this website. It's a knockoff. Oh, well, you have a chance to go to henryvacuumcleaner.com.
Is that what it is?
No, it's a company that makes real vacuum cleaners that this seems to be a knockoff of.
Oh, okay.
So they made it to look like a big vacuum.
One of those.
Yeah.
Okay, that would make sense. It says that it's actually made by Henry on...
Maybe they...
But who knows? Amazon could be wrong here, but this is the thing. There's a Henry little vacuum cleaner. It's so adorable.
And normally it sells for $18. I don't think so.
Wow. Yeah.
Wow.
At that price, you're getting into real money. You know, you're getting into... you could actually buy a vacuum cleaner.
Yeah.
For that. Yeah, Amazon is wrong a lot when it comes to who the original manufacturer is and things like that. But I don't know. You know, I'm in the middle. It's kind of cute. If you drop stuff on your desk a lot, this might be the product for you. If not, I'd say pass.
As long as they're not crackers.
As long as it's not crackers. As long as it's not saltines. Now I've made a mess. A really bad mess. This is what I do for the show. Okay.
Do you own a real vacuum?
Yeah, I do, luckily. Oh, okay. We're going to have to pull it in here and get it working. Let's see what magic I can do as we head into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn. Look at that. Clean. Completely clean, this desk. Look at that.
Oh, wow.
Magic. Absolutely.
Wow, what'd you put it? He must have hit high.
Magic.
Right?
There's the carpet over there needs to be cleaned pretty badly, but this desk is clean. What do you got for us this week, Dickie?
Okay, our video is from Brian Horowitz, and it was in response to a request like a month or two ago where I said, has anybody bought anything on Indiegogo? And if they did, would they show us what they bought and if they used it? So the note came, this is a video using software I backed on Indiegogo back in 2013 called Face Rig. And here is his video using what he bought.
Okay.
Online.
Hi, Dick and Chad. You asked for videos on something we bought on Indiegogo. Well, this is a project called Face Rig that I backed back in 2013. And as you can see, it's a digital avatar replacement and has motion tracking as you move your head, nod, blink, that kind of thing.
That's kind of cool.
It does lip sync, which is okay. I paid $10 for two licenses with the promise of being able to upgrade one of the licenses to the mobile version when it became available. They ended up doing a freemium model on the mobile app, so I still have an unused license laying around, but for $10, that's not too bad. This is just being recorded directly through the FaceRig interface, but one of the interesting things that it does is it creates a virtual webcam on your computer, so any app such as Skype or Hangouts or YouTube Live or anything where you can use your webcam, this can intercept it, and instead of displaying your webcam, display your digital avatar. So I just thought this was kind of interesting. I backed it back in 2013. It came out in 2014, and it's still under pretty active development. I get updates through Steam quite often for it, and I get updates through their campaign. They're also doing a commercial and industrial version that has full body tracking and stuff, where this home version only does face tracking and head movement. There's 56 different avatars that come with it that you can choose from, and 32 different backgrounds. And then, of course, they have add-on DLC packs where you can purchase more avatars and backgrounds and stuff like that. But just thought this was pretty interesting. I thought I got a pretty good deal for $10. I play with it quite a bit, and it's pretty interesting. I love the show, guys, and thanks for watching the video.
That That's awesome.
Think it is too. $10 for two licenses?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, the Kickstarter prize, yeah, definitely. It's funny, I've actually seen this before. There's actually a pretty popular Twitch streamer who uses Face Rig to play Twitch games. And you can see this is a Shiba Inu dog. This is a very popular type of dog.
Oh, how funny.
Yes. They put like a chair behind the dog and a headset on the dog. And then the dog will also, they have something set up where when it sings loud enough, he kind of goes into a super mode where I don't even know how to describe it. It's like a dance party or something like that. But you can see he's bouncing his head over around using the headset. And the headset will also change between streams. So you can, see other streams where that headset, right now it's kind of on his cheeks, but he'll have them where it's like right on his ears and stuff like that. There's all sorts of different things to do. But this Face Rig technology is really, really, really nice stuff. And
because as he's moving his head and blinking, I thought it was great. I thought it was going to be like $50 or something.
Right, exactly. So. No. It's just normal price
yeah,
stuff.
So that was from Brian Horowitz. Brian Horowitz says, P.S. I was the one who sent in the double AUK plasma lighter.
Oh, wow.
Remember, we had a plasma lighter, and then yes. Brian sent in and said, wait a minute, there's one that has overlapping arcs.
Yes. So good.
So. So Brian, you'll get that April Mad Magazine, which the No Trump in This Issue cover, although there is Trump in that issue. Don't worry about that. And my elevator sign, and you'll get one of those Alfred E. Newman pictures also. And I think we're out of videos from people who haven't sent in videos before. So if you want to send in something for next week's show, do it right away. Make a video, 2 to 3 minutes. Something you bought online, something that you have in the cellar, pretty much anything. We will take anything entertaining, okay, that involves a gadget. So make a little video, put it on YouTube as you're uploading it. Right before you upload it, click the little box that says unlisted, and then send the link to mail@gizwiz.tv. If you live in the U.S. or Canada, you get the Mad Magazine and the Alfred picture. If you live outside, somewhere else in the world, we will give you a shout out here on the show. Okay, but do something right away. We need a video for next week. And like I said, we do have a lot of videos, repeat videos, but we're trying to induct new people into the Dick's Gadget.
The Video Hall of Fame.
The Video Hall of Fame.
Everybody who's watching as a gadget, please submit. Thank you so much to those who take the time. With that, let's jump into the letter.
And our letter is from a longtime Giz Wiz fan and contributor, Moses, who says, I see this month's gadget of the month theme, and I thought you would like this as a desk toy. So let's go to the link he sent.
Ooh, the Kingpin Desktop Mini Bowling Alley.
The Mini Bowling
Alley. We can get 10% off, Dick. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, well, whoa. That would bring it down. Oh, I'm
Holy
still not going to spend $36.
It would be $4 off. Holy cow.
But if you're an executive with an expense account, this is a good way to while away the hours while you're on boring meeting phone calls or boring Skype calls.
I like that the base is made out of wood. I like that touch.
Yeah, that is nice. So you can bowl right at your desk. Desktop bowling.
Desktop bowling. I like it. I like
Moses,
it.
Moses, thank you for that.
Yeah,
it looks like it comes in a variety of woods, too, so I guess it's all natural.
Here, let me see. Oh, there's all this Stack Social. I've never heard of this website.
Neither have I.
But, yeah, they have all sorts of stuff in here. Wow. Well, that's perfect. That's absolutely perfect. Desktop bowling. IRL. I love it. Love it. Kingpin Desktop Mini Bowling Alley for $40 on Stack Social. Thanks, Moses. Hey, you know who I want to give a big thank you to? Our patrons. Patreon.com/GizWiz. You guys are the most fantastic people ever. Thank you so much for supporting this show. You guys make it happen every single week. How Patreon works, they're a platform for people to support independent content creators like ourselves. And we have our Patreon at patreon.com/GizWiz, where you support every time we upload an episode, you guys put in just a little bit. Thank you guys so much for all of your support. Yeah, it's just absolutely amazing. Some people don't want to support every single episode. They only want to support once. We accept PayPal donations through our website, has been a little while since we've been there. Gizwiz.tv, is the place to go. And then click the Patreon, tab at the top. Gizwiz.tv is also where we keep all of our episodes that we've recorded. And you can check out the show notes. Wait, there's one more GizWiz in here. GizWiz.biz. It's not the same as .tv. And there, that's Dick's site where he writes up all of the gadgets that we talk about in nice long paragraphs, lots of prose. And while you're there, make sure to play What the Heck Is It? It's the show where Dick chooses a gadget from his warehouse, takes a photo of it, and this is the whole gadget. This is the entire gadget. This isn't just a part of it. This is all of it. And you have to guess what the heck it is. We take correct answers and we take clever answers. This is pretty obvious to me that this gadget is actually from the future. This is one of the first times this is a from the future gadget. In the future, this is what pencils will look like. There's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers and 24. Double the Mad Magazines for hilarious, clever, interesting, and unique answers. And this is the Mad Magazine you're going to be trying to win. No Trump in this issue. Signed by Dickie D himself.
Exactly, and that is also the issue that has my Royal Chef elevator certificate inspection sticker with. So it looks like you would see the kind of thing in the elevator with all the handwritten comments.
If I don't see that at the mad offices in the elevator.
Oh, it'll be all over the place.
I'm sure. Trust me. With that, I think we've come to the end of our show. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Make sure you subscribe, gizwiz.tv. Make sure you join the chat room. Thanks, everyone who's in there. And we'll see you next time on the Gizwiz.
I'll be here.